This is David Hutchison, Associate Professor of New Testament at Southwestern Baptist Theological Seminary. I want to talk to you today about how to use the critical apparatus in Nestle Lawn 28. In particular, how do we understand all of the different symbols that the editors use? So let's take a look at some readings in 1 John. Here in verse 2, we see this T that kind of looks like a plus without the very top portion. If you think of it as a plus, this will help you to know that this is an insertion or an addition. So right here after chi, some manuscripts add the word ha. Now we've moved down to verse 3, and if you see this O next to the word chi, this is for an omission, O for omission. So the word chi is omitted by this group of manuscripts. And you see that they will list the evidence for other readings first, and then the reading in the text. This is a different procedure than UBS. UBS will list evidence for the reading in the text first. So this is just a different way of doing things. Now notice we have another O, this time with the number 1. Here's another omission. This is the word de. It's omitted by this group of manuscripts right here. They use the 1 because we've already had the symbol O by itself. Then we would have O2, O3, O4, and so forth. Now if we want to see how we do an omission of several words, let's jump to 2:23. So here we are in verse 23. This square will indicate the beginning of an omission of several words. So the square is the beginning, and this backslash is the end. So these words right here are omitted by this group of manuscripts over here on the right. Let's go back to 1:4. Now we have just a different word, a different reading. So you see this word hemes. It looks like the top left corner of a square or an angle iron. This is how we indicate a different reading, an alternate reading. So instead of the word hemes, some manuscripts have humin. Right here by the word hamon, we see the same angle iron, the same top left corner of a square, but with a dot. This is how we indicate the next alternate reading. So we'll have a dot, and then after the dot, we would have the 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm using the PC version of Accordance for the apparatus right now, and you see this little bitty rectangle right here? This is supposed to be the diamond shape. It's not showing up properly here. I did check the Mac version, and the Mac version shows up just fine. What the diamond will indicate is competing readings, each with equally strong evidence. So the reading in the text here, 1 John 1:4, is hamon, but the editors consider there to be equally strong evidence for this reading, humon. So is this our joy or your joy? Jumping ahead now to 1:7, you see Yesu tu huiu autu surrounded by these angle brackets. This is how we indicate an alternate reading of more than one word. So the open bracket will indicate the beginning and the closed bracket will indicate the end. So instead of Yesu tu huiu autu, some manuscripts read Yesu Christu tu huiu autu. Now I've moved 1 John 2:27 for another example of an alternate reading of more than one word. So the first one here is mene in humin. Then I have another example, this time with the dots. This indicates the next one, al hos. And then another one with the number 1, ta autu chrisma. Now let's return back to 1 John chapter 1. Now in verse 5, you see this squiggly little S. This is the symbol for a transposition. Here's where the transposition begins, estin, and here's where it ends, haute. Here we have another transposition indicated by the squiggly S plus 1. Here the transposition pertains to the words in, auto, uk, estin. So we have 4 words. And it's worth noting here how they will show you the transposition sometimes. Instead of reprinting all the words, they simply have 3, 4, 1, 2. So that means third word, fourth word, first word, second word. This is a space-saving way to show you the different word order. Now I've jumped over to Mark 1:1 to show you the brackets on huiu, theiu. Brackets will indicate that these words are of doubtful authenticity. The editors are not sure if these words are original. At the end of Mark, we have the double brackets. This indicates an early insertion in the textual tradition, according to the editors. You may know that the ending of Mark is much disputed, and so here we see these double brackets.